Even in the media now, that the Muslim community in the UK is responsible of radicalization.
But it's not true. It's ignorance.
And there are many other reasons for this kind of.
There's many ignorant people in the world.
Dr. Hen.
Thank you very much. I'll just make it very clear and to a few points. First of all, it becomes a must, a compelling duty to build coalition. You cannot do it without that. Whether you have the largest group, umbrella group, and you have another one, those have to communicate and connect and coordinate. It becomes like takbirat al-ihram for dukhul al-salah. Allahu Akbar, you have to do it. No way. You have to do it. Actually, this is number one. A part of it, capacity building is a must. It's more important nowadays than the food distribution. Capacity building of the local community. The people who will be able to build Syria. I'm not talking about to build the Raqqa or Madaya, to build Syria again. And we believe that you'll be able to do it. Number two is, as you all talked about education, it has to be non-traditional for a phase. This is a phase. Non-traditional educational system focusing on skills education and vocational training. This is very important. We don't have the fund to go for the full traditional education, but we need to actually to pass this phase with non-traditional vocational and skills education. On the livelihood, we need to start with the market. Build the local village market. And start with the profession that is the easiest, which is agriculture and livestock. Most of the cereal and farmers. Don't go to the very complicated profession and you invest in it and it might take years. But planting and animal husbandry or animal livestock. This is the second. Research is not on our table at all. Those people in UK, that's why they were actually a little bit frustrated because we don't have figures. Every time Andrew and Claire are asking for figures, figures, figures. We don't want any more emotional speeches. We want figures. Won't spend some of our fund in research to provide governments with the right papers or the right evidence-based. Otherwise, those people will listen to you, yes, and they cry with you, but they cannot do anything for you because you don't have figures on you. The last one, you must attend coordination meeting run by other INGO and UN. It is like the first one. When you go to pray, you say Allahu Akbar, you must attend this meeting as another Allahu Akbar. Because you have to learn, connect, communicate, then educate them. Because you have the know-how in the local on the local ground. And they need to know from you first-hand information. If we don't say attend it because they are Christian or they are whatever it is, we become a dead meat. We don't want to become a dead meat because all of us, we need to build Syria. And we thank Claire. And we thank Andrew for making this trip. They struggled to take clearance from the government to come here. So you have to struggle to give the right information to them to deliver the message on behalf of you to become your ambassadors.
Thank you.
And thank you, both of you.
Thank you.